Hold on, hold on. What does this mean? When somebody dies, like the story of the rich man, he died. When he died, immediately his spirit, his soul went to hellfire. But the body was still here on earth. And the body was buried. We're told the rich man died also and was buried. And then he found himself, his spirit and his soul, in hell. And he lifted up his eyes and he saw Abraham afar off. And he said, Father Abraham, send Lazarus to me to just cool my tongue with a drop of water, because I am tormented. Where? In this flame. There's fire there. That's where the spirit and the soul goes immediately a sinner dies, immediately a backslider dies, immediately a false prophet dies, a false teacher. That's where they go immediately. The spirit, the soul, they go there to hell. But the body is still here and is buried. And then on the day of resurrection, the power of God will raise that body, and the soul and the spirit that had been in hell since that man died will join to the body, and then spirit, soul and body, the complete man, will now go to the lake of fire. Hell has fire. There's burning, there's suffering, there's agony, there's darkness in hellfire. And is the spirit and the soul that is there now on this day, great white throne judgment. The spirit and the soul and the body will now join together. And it says death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. What that means is that death and hell cast in lake of fire, nobody will be dying anymore, because all those who go to that lake of fire, they'll be there forever and ever and ever. Suffering, eternal suffering, everlasting suffering, it's a place of suffering. They cannot come out of that place. And that's what it says in verse 15. And whosoever a churchman, whosoever a churchwoman, whosoever a backslider, whosoever a sinner, whosoever an idol worshiper, whosoever was not found written in the book of life, was cast into the lake of fire. That's why the Lord is saying that you do everything possible, if you have not repented, to turn away from sin and to say a final forever bye-bye to sin. And whatever is happening, you set your mind, you set your heart on that heavenly home, and you say, this hell, I will not be there. Listen to me. There are people that play with their souls. You steal now, and you know that the thieves will get to hell. And then after stealing, what if you had an accident and died without a chance of repentance? There are people, when they're sick, because I am sick, there's nobody to pray for me. My people are saying they will carry me somewhere, and they carry you to the idol shrine. And then while you are there in the idol shrine, you die there. You will go to hell. Why don't you endure? Even if you're sick, even if you are suffering, even if you are not healed, the suffering of sickness cannot be compared with the suffering of hellfire. That sickness, even if you are not healed, you will die. And when you die, you're free from that sickness. But if you are carried to the idol shrine, if you are carried to a place of occultism where they say they are praying and they're throwing this and splashing this on you, and you die there, no matter who buries you, you will go to hell. It's hellfire. That's the reason why you say, whatever happens, whatever I go through, whatever the suffering, whatever the need. Maybe you are barren, and because you are barren, they say come here, they say come there, and they take you somewhere to give you something to eat, mark your body, rub this on you. What's that? That's idol worship. What's that? That's occultism. What's that? You're serving the devil right there, because you're looking for children. If you die there, or if you die on your way back, and you don't have a chance to repent, you will go to hell. That's why you're saying, whatever price it will take, and whatever I need to give up, whatever, in whatever condition I need to remain, I'm going to remain, because that heaven, I will not miss it. I said that heaven, I will not miss it. Somebody there, that heaven, I will not miss it. You will not miss it in Jesus' name.